Hi, so I want to explain you like what's been happening, right? So I send you the first lesson, what is Bitcoin and more information, and you probably saw already that there is a thing like about market cap, right? So you got documents like a form of PDF about the lesson where you can find homework and as well additional links for spreadsheets that you can see how the market cap was changing in that period of time, right? So let's say additionally, I want to explain you what it is so you kind of would be beware for future investments or trading. You can see what's happening. So if you can see, there is a link like market cap, com, currency, Bitcoin market. So you can click on that, or I have already prepared market cap. It's just plain market cap. So, what we're gonna see here, it's pretty much like how everything it's involved. So you can see a lot of crypto tokens and as well like different cryptocurrency right here. So you can see the price and how what's happening, right? But let's stick on the first like 10th of them. You see Bitcoin is first, Ethereum is second, Binance Coin, Tether, Ripple, what's gonna be removed probably soon, Litecoin and Bitcoin Cash, right? We see the red, it's mean that what happened in the last 7 days. So it went up and down. As well, we see which one was green, what is maintained growing up, but just in generally they grow up, right? So we see price. We see 24-hour volume, but let's begin with that. What is market capitalization, right? So you can call it simply market cap. Simply defines the current share price multiplied by the total number of existing shares. In cryptocurrency terms, this means the current price of the coin times the total number of coins in the market, often referred to a circulating supply. So we see price, we see 24 hours, we see market cap. What is market cap now? It's like over 915 like billions, right? And as well, we see circulating supply. So circulating supply, it's pretty much how do you calculate it? So market cap of coin is calculating using a formula that equals market cap is the total circulating supply, what is 18 millions of Bitcoin. We multiply by the price what Bitcoin costs now. So when you multiply these numbers, you receive a market cap, right? So I think you kind of understand, right? So in any other coin, let's say we take off, let's say Litecoin, price is 117. We multiply by a supply, right? By circulating supply, and we receive market cap. And as well as explanation, right? That market cap means that current price of coin times the total number of coins in the market been multiplied, right? So we receive market cap from that. So as well, what is important to understand is that the term of circulating supply refers to the number of cryptocurrency coins or tokens what is already in the system, right? So it can be mined or available now, or what people hold now. So in general, now this is how much people hold in circulating supply, how much it's available now or been in used. So pretty much the volume, what is right here, it's volume, and as well we can see volume of percentage. It shows on what price did it went up, right? Or what amount in 24 hours went down. So pretty much the volume is the total amount of anything swapped around in the certain period of time. So period time can be 1 hour, 24 hours, 7 days, 2 days, 5 days. You can see volumes of percentage changing. So 24 hours and 7 days, it's a volume. An exchange usually shows its own volume for each crypto, as we see here, right? That is the amount traded on the particular exchange program or in some different like stock or forex or whatsoever, right? So what's been now used for trading. So this is what I want that you will understand as well in this first lesson, that it's a lot of cryptocurrency what been involved. And I want that you will see the market cap, you know, like how much money is in cryptocurrency, like comparing to euros or dollars or Canadian dollars, right? So market cap, this is pretty much how much money are invested in cryptocurrency. So we see billions. We see a lot of money as well. We see volume of each, like circulating supply, how many coins are there out, right? How many tokens are there? And as well, we can see volume, we can see what price. So wrapped Bitcoin and pretty much Bitcoin is exactly the same thing, but run on Ethereum. So you can go down and just check other coins, sorry, and you can calculate it, right? Like how many is supplies, right? How many, what differences was in 24 hours or 7 days. So you can scroll down. It's pretty much over like 6,000, even more. So in general, up, coin market cap shows you market cap, what is in general, like out there as well, like 24 volume, Bitcoin, cryptocurrencies, how many tokens. So it's in general, now it's over 8,000 cryptocurrencies. So it's mean it can be a coin, it can be a token, and like altcoin, right? And as well markets. So it's pretty much gives you understanding. So even if you click, let's say, on Ethereum to see more, because it's number two, it will show you that the low, it's 1,511, and the high, it's 1,710, like in 24 hours. It went up on 7.57%. As well, it gives you a little bit more understanding, like overall, right? The market, it shows you all the market, right? And pretty much you can see what been happening, what been market cap on June 7th, what been price, what its price towards Bitcoin. So for example, one Ethereum June 14th of 2017, its price was $372, what equaled by that price to Bitcoin 0.14. So you can understand like more, it will show you like volume, how it grow, you see like it was growing process and much more, like trading volume. So trading volume, it's how much been traded already, like market cap, you know, like what it was, the price change of volume for 24 hours, low and highs, market cap, right? So what we know what it is. And as well, like much more. So it's good for you to understand a little bit more about it so that you can choose invest instead of Bitcoin to other altcoins. What has promising future for you, you know? Maybe you can afford to buy Ethereum, or you can afford to buy Litecoin, or you can buy, let's say, other tokens like Bitcoin Cash. So just for recall, you have to, in your homework, to explain me by your words. Don't copy all the text. Just write what is market cap, what I tried to explain you. What is circulating supply? How do you count? What is formula of calculating market cap, right? So it's total circulating supply, you multiply by price of each coin, right? So each coin price is, let's say, $248, you multiply by circulating supply, right? As well, what is circulating supply? So you really have to understand what it is, right? And I hope that it helps you like this lesson, because you should understand bigger picture, how to make money by checking the stock market. How does coin market, its cap, it's like improving, what is the price? So you will be more secure with your finances by earning money. So this lesson one, and I hope that you understand. If you have some questions, just ask. Don't hesitate without asking. Ask, and I will check your homework. So it will be good if you could send me homework by next week, Monday or Tuesday. And on Wednesday, we will start already learning about how to register, how to already create your digital wallet, how to buy, how to purchase, how to do all verification. So it will be two different apps what we will be using. So additionally to that, I hope you understand, and yes, staying positively, learning is the power, it's a knowledge.